And good evening for folks joining us on Facebook. Just want to kind of bring you up to date as to what new information we have as of the 7 o'clock advisory and kind of delve into some of the details of the storm itself and potential impacts. I don't want to nail down those numbers quite yet, as there are still far more uncertainty and more questions than there are answers. A very similar path to what Delta took, and very similar to Delta, you don't really know more until it gets into the Gulf and you kind of see what the structure of the storm looks like and you begin to see what influences the steering currents have on its future trajectory. Right now, though, good news, winds have not come up, still at 80 miles an hour. Forward motion has increased slightly. That also good. And what's also good is that the pressure has come up by 2 millibar. So it is not a strengthening storm, a little weaker, in fact. Winds are still at 80, and it is still a dangerous storm. So I don't want to ever say that these storms, even tropical storms, can be deadly in and of themselves. So I don't ever want to downplay a tropical system. But also, we are not in August, September, or early October. This is a late October storm. They tend not to be nearly as powerful, especially for the United States. Now, as the storm moves toward the Yucatan, hopefully it doesn't intensify anymore. We'd like to see it maybe just plateau at that strength. Over the Yucatan, we will see what influences that land interaction does. If you remember, Hurricane Center didn't do a great job of Delta's impacts over the Yucatan, or influences, I should say, over the Yucatan. They really thought it was going to maintain itself as a very strong hurricane, and that was not the case. It rapidly weakened by quite a bit before reemerging over the water and into the Gulf. So let's see what happens as we get into tomorrow. We'll have more answers by later tomorrow once the storm emerges into the Gulf of Mexico, because we'll see what the storm strength is, what the structure looks like. Are the storms still around the center, or are they starting to be displaced off to the east? Will the wind shear and dry air really start impacting the center of the storm? Some things that computer models don't always do a great job of. And we'll also start to see late Tuesday and into Wednesday, beginning of a turn toward more the north, and that will continue through Wednesday. And then by Wednesday, late evening, early night, making landfall somewhere in southeast Louisiana. But again, this is just showing you where the center of the storm is. It's possible that the strongest storms, the heavier rainfall, may be well displaced off to the east. And it's also possible, like we saw with Marco. Do you remember that? We had the little swirl of Marco right near the mouth of the river, and all of the strongest winds and heaviest rainfall, because of wind shear and dry air, were well off to the east. As a matter of fact, it was more over Panama City than it was over southeast Louisiana. And that very well could be what the structure of the storm looks like as it gets into the central and northern Gulf of Mexico, with dry air, cooler water, and stronger wind shear starting to push the storm, and mainly a lot of the thunderstorms, off to the east. So we'll wait and see what happens. And kind of like a lot of tropical systems, they're very much a wait and see. We have started to get better agreement on the computer models, but I'll start to really buy into this more by tomorrow. And again, this is only showing you the center line. It is not showing you where the impacts lie. As I mentioned earlier, the steering currents are pretty cut and dry. Big ridge is guiding the storm right now toward the northwest, and eventually a turn toward the north as it becomes kind of right in between the Zeta, in between the upper ridge and a deepening upper trough over Texas. Then the upper trough takes over and begins that northeasterly motion, also introducing, as that trough gets closer, stronger wind shear, which will also help to weaken and disrupt the storm. Rainfall amounts, we haven't really seen these type of forecast graphics verify very well this season. So at the moment, we're going with kind of a range of maybe 2 to 4 inches, with some areas a little bit more, especially east. But if it ends up being that most of the convection with Zeta is well off to the east, then we may not see nearly these type of totals. We may be more in line with what Baton Rouge is expecting, 1/4 inch. That's very possible. Coastal flooding will be a risk, as we are under a storm surge watch. 4 to 6 foot for most of our coastline and in Lake Bourne. 2 to 4 foot storm surge in Lake Pontchartrain and Lake Maurepas, so that could lead to some flooding in the river parishes. And then as you go west of Port Fourchon, the storm surge risk is at around 2 to 4 feet. These are areas outside of the risk reduction system. These are areas, unfortunately, that always flood with a possible tropical system. One thing that we'll have to watch more than anything than the rain or the storm surge is the wind, because if those stronger tropical storm force and near hurricane force winds stay near the center, if the center does move over southeast Louisiana, then that puts us under more of the bullseye of some of the stronger and more damaging winds. winds. Obviously, they're going to be a little bit more from the center east, but that does put the threat of maybe those tropical storm force winds moving over even metro New Orleans. That'll be something we have to watch into late Wednesday. However, if most of the storms with the near the center of Zeta become so far removed to the east, it may also take some of those strongest winds off to the east as well. And again, something that is a very much a potential right now. We're also going to be watching the risk, as always with these landfalling storms, of some weak isolated tornadoes that may kind of get churned up within the circulation of the storm. But as I mentioned, right now, incredibly dry air over the Gulf of Mexico, and you can see the motion in the central and northern Gulf. There is strong wind shear now, and it's only going to increase as the upper trough, which is almost just off of our map here over the desert southwest, as this starts to approach, that wind shear is only going to increase. I really think we're going to see the structure of this storm, especially in to the central. So maybe by Wednesday, the storms with Zeta really getting removed off to the east and hopefully even taking some of the strongest winds away as well as that moisture starts surging up. Again, strong upper trough and a very strong cold front will start to improve conditions as we get into Thursday. So luckily, whatever impacts we do see, this is not going to be a prolonged issue. As a matter of fact, once that front moves on through, we're going to get strong northerly winds, which will help push the water away from our coastline. So right now the focus is on the Hurricane Zeta, after which by Thursday we're watching a very strong cold front to move through the area. As I mentioned, we're going to have a complete update and a new track, though I'm not expecting too much of a change, coming up on Eyewitness News at 10. For now, I'm Chief Meteorologist Chris Franklin.